Good morning, everyone. This is Harlambos Pissouros, senior analyst at IronFX, bringing you the morning comment for the 1st of July. Bank of England's Carney says easing may be required over the summer. Yesterday, Bank of England Governor Mark Carney stated that, in his view, some monetary easing will likely be required over the summer. Sterling dipped on this news while the FTSE 100 rose well above its pre-referendum levels. Carney's comments confirmed our view that in the post-referendum era, in case the bank faces a trade-off between curbing high inflation on the one hand and boosting faltering growth and employment on the other, it would choose the latter and it would be tolerant of high inflation for a short period. As Carney recently ruled out negative rates, the MPC may only have 225 basis points rate cut bullets left in the chamber, considering the rate is currently stands at 0.5%. This implies that the bank may prefer to introduce unconventional measures such as expanding the QE program. This doesn't mean that we rule out any rate cuts, though. We see the possibility for a rate cut in summer months and or QE expansion, with the most likely candidate being August, when the bank releases its quarterly inflation report. We continue to see the risks around the pound as tilted to the downside, partly because the political situation remains highly uncertain. We also expect to see foreign investment inflows slowing due to this uncertainty, something that could rapidly widen the current account deficit and thereby add more downward pressure on sterling in the foreseeable future. Overnight, Japan's headline and core CPI rates for May declined further into the negative territory, while the Tankan survey showed mixed results, but indicated that overall business sentiment remains subdued. On top of a strong yen and an uncertain global environment, we believe that this data put even more pressure on the Bank of Japan to ease policy in the foreseeable future, perhaps as early as at its July meeting. As for today's events, during the European day, we get the final manufacturing PMIs for June from France, Germany, and the Eurozone as a whole. However, as these are expected to confirm the preliminary estimates, any reaction in the euro could remain muted. In the UK, the manufacturing PMI for June is expected to fall slightly below the critical 50 line. However, given that these data were collected in the pre-referendum period, we believe that they are likely to attract less attention than usual, and thus any reaction in sterling may remain muted. From the US, we get the ISM manufacturing PMI for June. The index is expected to have risen, albeit only marginally. Given that the market, the Philadelphia Fed, and the Empire State manufacturing indices all exceeded their forecasts for a modest increase and spiked in June, we see the possibility for a bigger than expected increase in the ISM print as well. A positive surprise could raise speculation that the manufacturing sector may have started regaining some of its lost glamour and could bring the dollar under renewed buying pressure. The final market manufacturing PMI for June is also coming out, but the market usually pays more attention to the ISM figure. We have three speakers scheduled for today: ECB Executive Board members Benoit Guer and Peter Pryde, as well as Cleveland Fed President Loretta Mester. For more information, including technical analysis, please read the full comment on ironfx.com or download our app and get all the information you need to trade. Also, you can follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, or circle us on Google+ to get more trading ideas. This is Harlambos Pissouros, senior analyst at IronFX, wishing you solid trading.